Hello everyone, I'm Sonali Korde, the founder of the offbeat travel company SAMSONA Getaways. Today, in continuing our series of duologues, we have an expert with us who is an expert in Japan. So I would like him to introduce himself.
Thank you, Sonali. My name is Rajesh Vaidya. My company name is Hikari Partners, and mine is the only company in India which only goes to Japan.
Oh, okay. So we have an actual Japanese expert. I have heard a lot about you, Mr. Rajesh Vaidya, and that is why I have decided to have a duologue with you. Let us start in the beginning. As we plan to travel to Japan, because Japan is something completely out of the way. Generally, people travel to Europe, America, Southeast Asia, which is very feasible. Japan is a little off the location. So let us begin at the beginning, that how do we go in for a visa for Japan?
The visa process is extremely easy. You don't have to go to the visa office, nothing. You just pay 1,500 rupees and your visa is done. And the only thing what you need is your income tax certificate, or if you are an employee, there's the employment certificate, that your leave sanction certificate. And okay. For a student, just their ID card is enough.
Oh. Okay. So the visa is comparatively cheap. How many days does it take for the visa to come?
It takes around 1 week.
1 week. So we have to plan properly in advance.
Yes,
Fine. What kind of visa is issued? Is it a tourist visa?
It's a tourist visa.
Okay, fine. Thank you so much for this information. Now, let us say I have around 5 to 6 days in hand. So can I plan my trip to Japan?
Yes, of course. I mean, the 5 days will be a little short, but what I suggest for those people is, instead of traveling all the six cities in those 5 days, you stay in one city. Like, we have that plan, like you stay in Tokyo for 6 nights.
Okay.
So that 3 nights you stay in Tokyo and 3 nights you see the nearby area.
Okay.
But if you have a better, if you have suppose the 8 nights or 10 nights, then I will suggest you can choose go to Osaka, Kyoto, Hiroshima, all those kind of a location.
Okay, fine. So I have heard that your USP is that you have stayed for many years in Japan and you have a command over the language and all. Can you please tell me a little more about yourself?
Yes, actually, I'm an IT engineer. I lived in Japan for 15 years.
Oh my God.
I was with JP Morgan, so I have nothing to do with the tours. It is just my passion to show Indian people the true Japanese color. So that's why I'm doing this.
Oh, that is wonderful. As you know, we are an offbeat travel company. So when we take our tourists to Japan, I would like to show them the real Japan instead of just the few laid out itineraries which the other tourism companies show. So are there any offbeat things to do in Japan?
There are a lot of things which you can do which other people can't even imagine to go.
Oh, okay.
I mean, that is exactly my USP. To show you the Japan which you cannot see with your eyes.
Oh, well, fantastic. And since you are such an expert, I've heard that you even suggest cuisine to Indian people, especially the Japanese cuisine which is suitable to Indian palate.
Yes. Yeah, so. I mean, mine is the only company in India which don't include food. That is because I understand that I'm not going to give you food. You are paying for your own food. Then why don't you eat food what you like? And oh. I'm there to help you because I'm the expert. I will tell you which restaurants is nearby, what to eat in that particular menu, what to order, which is good for Indian taste. That is my expertise.
Okay. Because what happens is, when we go out, we see different, list of the menu, and then we are at a loss as to what to order. So since you will be helping out with that, that would be wonderful. Okay. Then how do you propose to travel within Japan?
Within Japan, we use the local transport. By using the local transport means there are bus, train, bullet trains, metro trains, different kinds of the train transport, and people who love it, because that is how you actually come in contact with the Japanese people and their culture. Basically, my tagline is, you live in Japan like a Japanese.
Okay. Wonderful. Because obviously, if you do not mingle with the people over there, the natives, then you do not know their true traditions and their culture.
True.
Right. Absolutely. I also heard that it is a very good place to take kids. Like
That is true. I mean, many times I recommend the student parents that instead of spending 1 lakh, 2 lakh rupees on the education of the class fees, invest that money and take your children to Japan. Because if you take them to like Bangkok, Bali or some other destinations, they come with the empty headed. When they come back from Japan, they get a lot of charge. And there are many things it happens that, you know, when the father tells something to the son, he will not understand. But as I'm a tour guide, when I tell him, they understand.
That's what they, what happens is when they say that when teacher tells, the children listen.
Correct.
And when the parents tell the same thing, the children don't listen.
That is true, exactly.
Yes, I have learned that, I have heard that there are a lot of good lessons to be learned from Japanese children also. And instead of taking the children only to recreational places, we should take them where they can learn something and make their life a better one.
True.
Thank you so much, Mr. Vaidya, for joining us. And I hope that our guests, our viewers have learnt a lot from this small conversation that we've had. We will definitely bring a more in-depth conversation with Mr. Vaidya later on. And if you have any queries, you can post it to our website. That is www.samsonagetaways.co.in. You can email it to us at sonali@samsonagetaways.co.in. You can visit us on our Instagram platform at #SamsonaGetaways and Facebook at SamsonaGetaways. Thank you so much for this conversation. Thank you, Mr. Vaidya.
Thank you very much. Thank you.